గుడ్ మార్నింగ్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, వెల్కమ్ టు ద న్యూ సిరీస్ ఆఫ్ జనరల్ ఇన్సూరెన్స్ ఏజెంట్ ఎగ్జామ్ IC38 IRDAI, దట్ ఈస్ మోటార్ అండ్ నాన్ లైఫ్ ఏజెంట్ ఎగ్జామ్. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, ప్లీజ్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ మై ఛానల్ ఇఫ్ యు ఆర్ నాట్ ఇట్ సబ్స్క్రైబ్ అండ్ డోంట్ ఫర్గెట్ టు క్లిక్ ఆన్ లైక్ బటన్ అండ్ బెల్ బటన్. డియర్ ఫ్రెండ్స్, యాజ్ పర్ న్యూ సిలబస్ ఆఫ్ IC38 IRDAI, దిస్ టెస్ట్ కన్సిస్ట్ ఆఫ్ 50 క్వశ్చన్స్. ద టైమ్ డ్యూరేషన్ ఆఫ్ దిస్ టెస్ట్ ఇస్ 60 మినిట్స్. ద మ్యాక్సిమం మార్క్స్ ఆర్ 50 మార్క్స్. You have to score minimum 18 marks to pass this exam. Dear friends, as per new syllabus of IC38 IRDAI General Insurance Agent Exam, that is Non-Life and Motor Insurance Agent Exam, under Section 3, there are 6 chapters. Today, we are going to learn important question answers from these chapters, that is Chapter 14, Personal and Retail Insurance, Chapter 15, Commercial Insurance, Chapter 16, Claims Procedure. Dear friends, let us see the important question answers from these three chapters. Let us see the questions. Question number 1. Which of the below statement is correct with regards to a householder's insurance policy? What is the question? Householder's policy. Which is correct statement? Let us see the options. A named peril policy may be purchased as a less expensive. Yes, friends. Alternative to a comprehensive coverage policy that tends to offer coverage to most perils. Yes, friends. Option number is correct option, friends. Let us see other options. A comprehensive policy that tends to offer coverage to most perils. No. A named peril policy or comprehensive policy comes at the same price. No. With regards to a householder's policy, only a named peril policy can be bought. No, friends. This is not correct. So the option number 1 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 2. Under the shopkeeper policy, the insured may opt for an additional fixed plate glass and sanitary fittings cover. This will cover accidental loss of damage to which of the following? All of the above. Dear friends, fixed plate glass, sanitary fittings, neon signs, all of the above. Yes, friends, in previous videos I have given this tip. Whenever you see all of the above in this exam, please choose that option. If you don't know the answer, please straight away you can choose all of the above option, because there is no negative marking in this test. If you know the answer, yes, you can choose the answer, or else whenever you see this option, that is all of the above option, please choose that option. This is one tip to this exam. Next, question number 3. Motor insurance should be taken in whose name? Motor insurance should be taken in whose name? In the name of the vehicle owner. In the name of the vehicle owner whose name is registered with the regional transport authority. Dear friends, this is the correct option. This is the correct option. So motor insurance should be taken in whose name? In the name of the vehicle owner whose name is registered with the regional transport authority. What about other options? If the person who will be driving the vehicle is different from the owner? No. In the name of any family member? No. If the person who will be driving the vehicle is different from the owner? No, friends. Motor insurance should be taken in the name of the vehicle owner whose name is registered with regional transport authority. This is the first option is correct, friends. Next, question number 4. In householder's insurance, gold and silver ornaments are covered. Yes, friends. Gold and silver ornaments are covered. Contents of one's shop is covered. No. Gold and silver ornaments are covered. Cars owned by the family are covered. No, cars are not covered. Parcels sent by post are covered during transit. No, friends. Householder's insurance will cover gold and silver ornaments are covered. The option number 1 is correct, friends. Next, question number 5. Householder's insurance covers, again the same question. Householder's insurance also covers only the structure of the home. No, friends. Only the structure of the home. No. Only the contents of the home. No. Both the structure and contents, dear friends, these both are covered under householder's insurance cover. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Both structure and contents only when insured is not at home. No, friends, fourth option is not correct. Both the structure and contents, that is householder's insurance policy, covers the structure of the house and the contents of the house. This is correct option, friends. That is both the structure and contents is correct option. Next, question number 6. In shopkeeper's insurance, which of the following are not covered? Dear friends, the key point is not covered. They are asking not covered under shopkeeper's insurance. What is not covered? Machinery breakdown. Yes, friends, it is covered. Malicious damage. Yes, friends, it is covered. Business interruption. Yes, it is covered. Willful destruction by insured. Dear friends, in shopkeeper's insurance, willful destruction by insured is not covered. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 7. In shopkeeper's insurance, which of the following are usually not covered? The same question. Which of the following is not covered under shopkeeper's insurance? Money in counter at business premises. Yes, it is covered. Money in transit from bank to business premises. Yes, it is covered. Money in safe at business premises. Yes, it is covered. Money carried by customer to business premises. Dear friends, this is not covered. Money carried by customer to business premises is not covered under shopkeeper's insurance policy. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 8. Shop insurance covers dishonest acts of employees. Yes, friends, it covers dishonest acts of employees. Dishonest acts of insured, no, willful action or dishonest action of insured, not covered. So dishonest acts of employees, yes, it is covered under shop insurance coverage. Dishonest acts of customers, no, friends, it is not covered. Dishonest acts of money lenders, no. So the option number correct option, friends. Next, question number 9. A fire policy for commercial risks cover the perils of fire policy. What it is covered for commercial risks? Explosion, yes, it is covered. Implosion, yes, friends. Explosion and implosions are covered under commercial risk, that is fire policy. That means both of the above is correct, friends. None of the above, no. So a fire policy covers explosion as well as implosion. Dear friends, one more key point here I want to share with you. Whenever you see both option, maximum that option will be the correct option. Dear friends, if you don't know the correct option, you can choose this option, because in this exam there is no negative marking, so you can choose both option, that is both of the above option, if you don't know the answer. But at this stage you can choose. If you know the answer, yes, it is explosion and implosion. That means a fire policy covers both of the above is correct option, friends. If you don't know the answer, you can choose both of the above. So this is a key point where you can choose correct option. Next, question number 10. A business interruption insurance policy can be taken only in conjunction with standard fire and special perils policy. Dear friends, a business interruption insurance policy can only be taken in conjunction with standard fire and special perils policy. Under this policy, it covers a business interruption insurance policy. So standard fire and marine policy, no, friends. Marine policy is different. Standard and special perils, no, friends. Standard it is covering, but it is not covering fire. So the option number 3 is not correct. Standard engineering and marine policy, no, friends. Standard fire and special perils policy is a business interruption insurance policy that can be taken only in conjunction with standard fire and special perils policy. Next, question number 11. The premium for burglary policy depends on nature of insured policy, moral hazard of the insured himself, construction and location of the premises, all of the above. What is the answer? Dear friends, blindly you can choose all of the above, because burglary policy depends on nature of insured policy, moral hazard of the insured himself, construction and location of the premises. That means all of the above. Just now what I said, if you see, wherever you see all of the above option, blindly you can choose all of the above option. Here the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 12. Which of the below is covered under a money insurance policy? Money insurance policy. What is money insurance policy? Shortage due to error or omission, no, friends. Loss of cash from one's premises due to burglary. Dear friends, this is money insurance policy. Is the loss of cash from one's premises due to burglary is known as money insurance policy. Loss of money that has been entrusted to other than authorized person, no. Riot, strike and terrorism, no, friends. The option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 13. Fidelity guarantee insurance indemnifies. Dear friends, Fidelity guarantee insurance, Fidelity, employers against the financial loss suffered by them due to fraud or dishonesty of their employees. Dear friends, this is correct option, friends. Fidelity guarantee insurance indemnifies what? Employers against the financial loss suffered by them due to fraud or dishonesty of their employees. So the option number correct option, friends. Employers against the financial loss suffered by them due to fraud or dishonesty of their employer. No, friends, employer is not correct. Employees and employers against the financial loss suffered by them due to fraud or dishonesty of third party, no. Shareholders, company management, no, friends. Option number One is correct option, friends. That next question number 14. Which of the below can be covered under a banker's indemnity insurance policy? What is the policy? Banker's indemnity insurance policy. What are the options? Option number 1. Money, securities lost or damaged, whisked within the premises due to fire. Okay. Forgery or alteration of checks. Yes, okay. Dishonesty of employees with reference to money. Okay. These three are covered. That means option number 4. All of the above. Dear friends, just now what I said? Whenever you see this option, all of the above is going to be the maximum correct answer. So if you don't know the correct option, you can choose right away all of the above option. So the option number 4 is correct, friends. Next, question number 15. In case of a jeweler's block policy, damage due to property insured when it is in transit by registered parcel will be covered under, dear friends, section 3. Straight away you can choose section 3. Section 3 of general insurance says jeweler's block policy, that is the damage due to property insured when it is in transit by registered parcel will be covered. That means section number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 16. Delay in startup policy is also known as machinery loss of profits cover. No, advance loss of profits cover. Dear friends, delay in startup policy is also known as advance loss of profits cover. This is option number 2 is correct option, friends. Contractors all risk policy cover. No, contractors plant and machinery cover. No, friends, delay in startup policy is known as advance loss of profits cover. This is the correct option, friends. Next, question number 17. Which of the following is not covered under industrial all risks insurance? Industrial all risk insurance, what is not covered? Fire and special perils as per fire insurance practice. Yes, friends, it is covered. Larceny, dear friends, larceny, it is a type of theft or using others' machinery in your premises. It is not covered under industrial all risk insurance. That means larceny is correct option, friends. Machinery breakdown, electronic equipment. No, friends, larceny is not covered. The key word in this question is not covered. So the industrial all risk insurance do not cover larceny. What is larceny? Larceny is theft of others' instruments or using other instruments in your premises. If something happens to that instruments, it is not covered under industrial all risk insurance. So the correct option is 2, friends. Next, question number 18. Which branch of insurance offers cover against war perils? War perils. So what is the branch of insurance offers cover against war? Marine policies, aviation policies. So both of the above. Dear friends, just now I have given a tip that whenever you see both of the above option, please choose that option. Maximum that option will be the correct option. If you don't know the correct answer, please choose both of the above option whenever you see this option, because in this exam there is no negative marking. You can choose this option whenever you see this both of the above option. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 19. Under the Public Liability Insurance Act 1991, how much is the compensation payable for actual medical expenses? What is the cost? 12,500. Dear friends, the medical expenses are only 12,500 rupees under Public Liability Insurance Act 1991. So the maximum compensation payable for actual medical expenses is 12,500 rupees, friends. Option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 20. In engineering insurance, that is CAR, stands for contractors all risks. Dear friends, engineering insurance CAR stands for contractors all risks. Option number 2 is correct option, friends. Motor car, companies all risk, companies all requirements. No, friends, CAR stands for contractors all risks. So the option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 21. An employer insures himself from dishonest act of his employees by, what is the insurance? Fidelity guarantee insurance policy. Dear friends, fidelity guarantee insurance policy is the insurance policy taken by employer. That means he insures himself from dishonest act of his employees. This is the correct option, friends. Employees compensation policy, public liability insurance policy, declaration policy. No, friends, fidelity guarantee insurance policy is the correct option. Option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 22. Dash refers to the body of the ship. What is the body of the ship? Hull. Hull, H-U-L-L is refers to the body of the ship. Cargo, piracy, jettison. No friends, these three are not correct. So hull refers to the body of the ship is correct option, friends. Next, question number 23. Policy which covers loss or damage to aircraft. What is the insurance? Statutory liability, property insurance, aviation insurance. Dear friends, whenever you see aircraft insurance, that is aviation insurance. Money insurance, no friends. The option number 3 is correct option, friends. That is aviation insurance. Next, question number 24. Fire insurance policy does not cover damage to property even as add-on cover due to floods, earthquake, fire, bombing due to war. Dear friends, fire insurance policy does not cover damage to property even as add-on cover due to bombing due to war. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 25. Consequential loss, that is fire policy, covers what? Loss of profit due to damage to factory. Yes, it is. Loss of goodwill, no friends. Material wear and tear in machinery, no. Material losses due to foreign exchange fluctuations, no friends. This is not correct. This is not correct. This is not correct. So the option number correct one is correct option, friends. That is loss of profit due to damage to factory is consequential loss covers. That is consequential loss policy covers loss of profit due to damage to factory is correct option, friends. Next, question number 26. Premium in burglary depends on what are the factors? Security measures, location of premises, nature of property, all of the above. What is the correct option? Dear friends, all of the above. Whenever you see all of the above option, maximum that option will be the correct option. So choose straight away all of the above option. That is option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 27. Contractors all risk, that is CAR, car policy, is a variation of fire insurance, life insurance, engineering insurance. So engineering insurance stands, car stands for contractors all risk policy. So the engineering insurance option number 3 is correct option, friends. Marine insurance, no. So the correct option is 3, engineering insurance, contractors all risk policy. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 28. Employees compensation policy is a type of liability insurance. Fire insurance, no. Marine cargo insurance, engineering insurance. These three are not correct, friends. So employees compensation policy is a type of liability insurance. So the liability insurance option number 1 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 29. Money insurance policy covers cash in hand. Yes friends, option number 1 is correct. Money invested in mutual funds, no. Say money lying in saving bank, no. Money deposited with post office, no friends. Cash in hand covers under money insurance policy. So the option number 1 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 30. Which of the following activities would not be categorized under professional settlement of claims? So the key point is would not be categorized. The key point of this question is would not be categorized. Seeking information relating to the cause of the loss. Yes friends, it is not correct. Approaching the claim with a prejudice. So the option number 2 is correct option, friends. Which of the following activities would not be categorized under professional settlement of claims? That is approaching the claim with a prejudice. There must be no prejudice. So the option number 2 is correct option, friends. Ascertaining whether the loss was a result of an insured peril, for quantifying the amount payable under the claim. No friends, option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 31. Raj is involved in a car accident. His car is insured under a motor insurance policy. Which among the following is the most appropriate thing for Raj to do? Notify the insurer of the loss as soon as reasonably possible. This is correct option, friends. Notify the insurer at the time of insurance renewal. No friends. Damage the car further so as to receive a bigger compensation. No. This is not correct. Ignore the damage. No friends. Notify the insurer of the loss as soon as reasonably possible is correct option, friends. Next, question number 32. Compare claims investigation and claims assessment. Is both claims investigation and assessment are the same thing? No. Compare claims investigation and claims assessment. What is the difference? Investigation tries to determine the validity of the claim. Yes friends. Whereas assessment is more concerned with the cause and extent of the loss. This is correct option, friends. Investigation tries to determine the validity of the claim, whereas the assessment is more concerned with the cause and extent of the loss is correct option, friends. What about the next options? Assessment tries to determine. No friends. Investigation is done before the claim is paid. No friends. So So the compare claims, claims investigation and claims assessment is investigation tries to determine the quality of the claim, whereas assessment is more concerned with the cause and extent of the losses. Correct option, friends. Next, question number 33. Who is the licensing authority for surveyors? Surveyor Association of India? No. Survey Regulatory and Development Authority? No. Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, IRDAI, is the mother of all licensing authority for insurance agents, surveyors, or all insurance related authorized personnels. Who is the mother? Insurance Regulatory and Development Authority of India, that is IRDAI, Government of India. No, friends, the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 34. Which among the following documents is most likely to be requested while examining a cyclone damage claim? What is the damage claim? Cyclone damage claim. Coroner's report, report from fire brigade. No, friends, cyclone damage, there is no need of fire brigade report. Police report, let us see. Report from meteorological department. Yes, friends, option number 4 is correct, because cyclone is recorded by meteorological department. So the report from meteorological department is required in case of cyclone damage claim. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 35. Under which principle can the insurer assume the rights of the insured in order to recover from a third party the loss paid under a policy? What is this terminology? Contribution, discharge, subrogation. Dear friends, subrogation is the insurer assume the rights of the insured in order to recover from a third party the loss paid under a policy is known as subrogation. Indemnity. No, friends, the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 36. If the insurer decides that a certain loss is not payable because it is not covered under the policy, then who decides on matters? Insurer's decision is final? No. Umpire? There is no umpire in insurance policies. Arbitrator? No. Court of law? Court of law decides. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 37. Intimation of loss is to be made at the exact time of the loss, after 15 days, as soon as reasonably possible. Dear friends, option number 3 is correct option. As soon as reasonably possible, intimation of loss is to be made to the insurance company about the loss. Any time after the loss? No, friends, as soon as reasonably possible is correct option, friends. Next, question number 38. Investigation of loss is done by unlicensed surveyor? No. Licensed and qualified surveyor. Dear friends, investigation is done by licensed and qualified surveyor is correct option, friends. Insured's representative? No. Any person with a degree in engineering? No, friends, licensed and qualified surveyor will do the investigation of loss by licensed and qualified surveyor. So the option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 39. For personal accident claims, report of dash is necessary. For personal accident, who is going to give the report? Surveyor, doctor, police, coroner. Who is going to give? Doctor. So doctor report is compulsory or necessary for personal accident claims. So the option number 2 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 40. Independent surveyors are required for claims equal to or above dash as per the Insurance Act. What is the amount? 20,000, friends. Option number 3 is correct option. Independent surveyors are required for claims equal to or above 20,000 as per the Insurance Act. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 41. Claims assessed outside the country in case of travel insurance policies are assessed by, who is going to assess? Indian surveyors? No. Local surveyors in the country of loss? No. Insurers own employees? No. Claim settling agents named in the policy. So option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 42. In case of a fire claim, a report from the fire brigade is not required, is optional, is necessary in case of fire claim. Who is going to give the report? Brigade, that is fire report by brigade, that is a report from the fire brigade is correct option, friends. It is necessary, is part of the police report. No, friends, in case of a fire claim, a report from the fire brigade is required. Next, question number 43. What is TAT, that is TAT? Time and turn? No, friends. Delay time? No. Time and tide? No. Turnaround time. Dear friends, TAT stands for turnaround time. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 44. On payment of loss, salvage belongs to insurer. Insurer. On payment of loss, salvage belongs to insurer. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 45. Arbitration is a claim settlement process done by arbitrator chosen by the parties involved. This is correct option, friends. In the court of law, by a group of surveyors, arbitrarily by the insurance company's employees. No, friends. By arbitrators chosen by the parties involved is correct option, friends. Next, question number 46. Insurers under right of subrogation are allowed to recover the loss paid from shipping companies only? No. Railways and road carriers only? Airlines and port trusts only? No. Shipping companies and railway and road carriers and airlines and port trusts. So all are correct. That means when you see all in one option, so that option is going to be the correct option. So the option number 4 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 47. Which among the following is an example of coercion? What is coercion? Ramesh signs a contract without having knowledge of the fine print? No. Ramesh threatens to kill Mahesh if he does not sign the contract. Option number 2 is correct option, friends. Ramesh uses his professional standing to get Mahesh to sign a contract? No. Ramesh provides false information to get Mahesh to sign a contract? No, friends. Option number 2 is correct option, friends. What is coercion? Coercion is threatening to kill. So the coercion is Ramesh threatens to kill Mahesh if he does not sign the contract is correct option, friends. Next, question number 48. Which among the following options cannot be insured by Ramesh? Ramesh house, Ramesh spouse, Ramesh's friend. Dear friends, one cannot insure his or her friend. So the option number 3 is correct option, friends. Next, question number 49. Which element of a valid contract deals with premium? Offer and acceptance, consideration, free consent, capacity of parties to contract. Dear friends, consideration. Consideration is correct option, friends. Which element of a valid contract deals with premium? Consideration is correct option, friends. Next, question number 50 dash relates to inaccurate statements which are made without any fraudulent intention is known as misrepresentation. Misrepresentation is made without any fraudulent intention is known as misrepresentation. Contribution, offer, representation. No, friends. So the option number 1 is correct, friends. Dear friends, we have completed all 50 questions. So before submitting your question paper, please go up and check whether you have done all question answers or not. If not done, please check one answer. Because there is no negative marking in this exam, please don't leave blank without answering. One more tip in this exam, please don't use arrow keys, because arrow keys will change the answer. Like this, I am using downward arrow. This will change your answer selection. So don't use arrow keys on your keyboard in your exam. Okay, friends, once you feel all are done, then straight away you can submit your question paper. Yes, I am submitting. Yes, friends, you have successfully submitted your question paper. Yes, friends, you can see your result as soon as you submit your question paper in your real exam also. Let us see the result. I'm viewing the score. Dear friends, congratulations, you got all question answers are correct. 50 out of 50. Thank you, friends. Please subscribe my channel if you are not yet subscribed, and don't forget to click on like button and bell button. Bye. Thank you. All the best.